talking about the things that make your home service business go. Marketing, finance, systems, people. This is the Fight Club for Business podcast.
Makes me that much stronger, makes me work a little bit harder, makes me that much wiser, thanks for making me wider.
Awesome. Welcome back to Fight Club, everyone. Super excited to have you back with us this Tuesday morning. As you know, we are a group of self-employed industry experts, and we're here to help you work and fight for your business. We cover four areas of the business. We've got marketing, operations, employee management, and money. And we'd like to make this just a casual conversation to really help you find one area out of those four that you can focus on this week and move the needle forward in your business. So we're excited to have Daniel with us from SendJim today, and we're going to go ahead and do a little kind of round introduction, round robin style, and then get to know a little bit more about Daniel before we jump in all the fun stuff. So my name is Taylor Maroney. I co-own a power washing company in South Florida with my husband, and I've been working in marketing for about 5 years now. So welcome back to Fight Club and welcome, Daniel. Can you give everyone a kind of brief overview of you and SendJim and everything you've got to offer?
Absolutely. So I'm Daniel. I'm the CEO of SendJim. We have another product called Automate Motivate as well. We offer software products for the service industry. Either marketing is the big one, and then employee engagement is the second. And just personally, I understand and live and breathe the service industry. I own a carpet cleaning business, and I'm launching a concrete coating company. So I will, the proud owner of two service businesses as well. That's a little bit about me.
I did not know about the carpet company. It's like, yeah. And then the coating, like, you're not busy enough. Okay, another business. I love it. You have it right in this group, Daniel. I don't know how many businesses we own between all of us, but I think Tay even recently was like, and I was thinking about this other idea. So welcome to Fight Club. My name is Megan Likes. I'm the founder of Bookkeeping Academy Online. I educate and empower small business owners to know their numbers so that they can live more financially rewarding lives. I also own an accounting company, a full service accounting firm. So if numbers are not your thing, or if money is not your specialty, you can outsource all of that to my team at Likes Accounting Company. And I co-own a window cleaning and gutter cleaning company with my husband, Jeff, in Northern California. And I'm excited to be here on this Tuesday.
All right. And lastly, I'm Martha Woodward, and I co-founded Quality Driven Software and run a program called Culture First and Level Up. And it's all about building happier workplaces. So, and yes, on the side, I run a maid service as pretty much a absentee owner. So welcome to Fight Club, Daniel.
Thank you so much.
And you went out of order. We're out of practice. It's been a whole week.
Oh, my gosh.
My doggies were jumping in to add a little extra value this morning, so I muted myself. But I'm Michelle Myers, co-owner of Pink Collars, and we outsource your front and back office support needs. So if you are being mired down in calls, texts, emails, chats, and all that good stuff that keeps your business running, you can outsource that to our company. So thank you so much, Daniel, for being here, and welcome to Fight Club.
Thank you. Thanks so much for having me, ladies. I really appreciate it.
We're so excited to have you here. It's going to be a really fun topic, I think. Lots of value from lots of different angles. That's one of our favorite things to talk about.
Absolutely. So I might have a little bit of background noise. I'm outside because my dogs are being crazy. So they're locked inside today. So if you hear some extra wind with me, that's why. But I want to steal you, Daniel, and talk about a topic I feel a lot of business owners tend to forget about. And it's something that SendJim is absolutely amazing at, and it's relationship marketing and really taking your current clients and nurturing them throughout the year to make sure that they don't forget about you. Because we all want new customers, we all want new clients, of course, but what can you do to be able to, you know, nurture and take care of those current clients? How can you be able to move that needle forward in your business? So what is a way that SendJim really is able to take that and push that forward for business owners?
Yeah, Tay, that's a great topic, because I think it's the biggest opportunity for a lot of businesses, including SendJim itself, is to market to their existing customer list. they already know and love you, but how do you make sure that, you know, that they don't forget about you and they use you to the maximum extent possible, right? Yeah, so SendJim, what we can do and what I recommend every business does, and there's Patrick, I guarantee you he does this, but he enters his customers into a thank you follow-up sequence. And so that would look like, hey, immediately after the service, you're sending them a thank you and you're cementing that idea in their head that this is a fantastic company that I'm working with, right? They're saying something like, wow, I can't believe like my pressure washer or window cleaner that's normally like a transactional business is like thanking me and sent me this really nice message and asking if I had any questions or issues. So it's that thank you message. And then the second part of that sequence is following up at the right time, right? Making them aware of other services that you offer maybe in 3 months. And then in 6 months, hey, it's been 6 months since your last service. In 9 months, reminding them of other services you offer. And then in 12 months, reminding them again, hey, it's been 12 months since your last cleaning. Just keeping your business top of mind for them. And so our product is able to enter them into that sequence automatically. So we can use automations through your CRM to say, hey, when I close an invoice, enter this customer into that sequence so that it takes that burden off the business owner from having to keep track and follow up with all those things.
Automation, I think, is Michelle's favorite word. So I'm sure she's going to dive deeper into that. So I'll avoid the automation side of it for right now. But as far as you talked about transactional, you know, services. And I feel like that's something, even personally in our business this past year, that we learned to strive to kind of steer away from. Because like you said, it's so difficult to build a relationship off of transitional transactions with service businesses. You're really just treating them as if you're just there to take their money and then say, hey, okay, see you later. Good luck next year. And why not take that to the next step? Why not? You know, I think I was watching Bobby Walker, our favorite friend of Fight Club. He did a testimony on y'all's website, and he not only sends, you know, the thank you email, but he also does a couple voicemail bombs after to put a voice to the clients actually saying thank you and, you know, maybe even requesting a review. I don't really know the details of his voicemail, but you're taking it one step further to really personalize the experience for that client, which is something that most individuals in business are really not taking the step to do right now.
Yeah. When people have a personal connection with the person that they bought a service from, they are way more likely to buy from them again. They're way more likely to not look at price as a differentiator. And so those things can help you charge more, help you get repeat business, help you generate reviews. I mean, everything that the service business wants, that just creating that little bit of personal connection or relationship with is super, super valuable.
And even I'm going to tie in last week's kind of theme was trust, right? So last week we talked a lot about trust on Fight Club, and relationship marketing is a great way to build that trust, to be able to connect and have a personalized experience through trust, through a relationship that you as the business owner are now automating through a software like SendJim. So I honestly am really trying this year. That's our goal, is, you know, focusing heavily on relationship marketing and making sure our clients are consistently happy. So I'm even going to do my own homework this week. So I hope you guys do. But thank you so much, Daniel, for spending some time with me. And I'm going to pass you on to Megan.
Of course.
Awesome. Thanks, Tay. That's so good. So good. So I always struggle because I feel like there's so many questions I could ask you. So I'm going to let you choose your ending, your own destination between two. So one is, when you own multiple businesses, which I think we probably have a few listeners that do, it can be hard to like navigate the finances of two because they have to be kept separate, but yet they all come together at some point, whether that's in your personal finances or in your brain or in your life or with your staff or whatever it is. So we could talk about that. Or I would like to talk about the money related to marketing. I feel like this is something that's kind of interesting with SendJim, is that a lot of the marketing touches that we do through SendJim are soft touches, which means that sometimes they're harder to monetize. They're harder to like tag as, this is the lead source that brought in this much revenue. So I mean, like, do either of those speak to you like more? We only get to choose one because we're technically only got 5 minutes.
Yeah, I can speak to either of those, but let's do the second one. I just want to tell you, Megan, that money like and data speaks to me. Like, I love numbers. I'm a numbers person. I'm an engineer by schooling. So this is my wheelhouse. But yeah, we can speak to that second one.
Okay. So if that, I'm glad you said that one, because I have more like data in front of me related to the second one than I did the first one. The first one was more about feelings, but that's okay too. There's a lot of feelings in money. Okay. So related to the second one, SendJim, like when we're doing a 5 around or a 9 around mm-hmm. campaign, because we're already in a neighborhood and we're going to be doing work, like, I've really struggled with the way to track the results of that campaign, right? So you have the hard cost of the postcards, but then, you know, how do you track the results of that campaign? So I think one way we could do that is by putting a special phone number on it, right? That way we could actually track the incoming calls. But I wanted to hear like other ideas, like a voicemail bomb or sending brownies as a I'm sorry, or sending brownies as a thank you for this $1,000 job. Like, how do we monetize that? Like, you're building this relationship that's worth a lot of money, because hopefully our listeners know their lifetime average value of a client, right? But it's something I've really always struggled with SendJim, and I know the value's there, but I'm having a hard time like putting a dollar amount on that value. So I'm sure you get this question a lot, Daniel.
Yeah, I totally get it. And I'll be the first to say, like, Michelle would like this from a process standpoint and what her people do, but you want to train the person at your company that interacts with the customer to needle them in a nice way to find out how they heard about you, right? I have a good friend of mine sold an $18 million carpet cleaning business, and he struggled heavily with like identifying the channels in which people heard about him and the ROI for marketing activities. Because someone gets a postcard from a 5 around or a door hanger or a yard sign, and the first thing they probably do is go to your website, right? And there's a call tracking number on the postcard, but they go to your website or they go to your Google My Business and they look at your reviews, and then they click the phone number from there, or they submit a form on your website. And so the postcard may have generated that lead, but you can't measure that. Mm-hmm. So the most effective way for people out there that are struggling with this is train the person that picks up the phone to say, how did you hear about us? And they will tell you and say, oh, really? And like, ask a second question, right? If they say, oh, I just, you know, I found you online. Oh, where did you find us? You know, was it Facebook? Were you searching on Google? Right? And like, really get detailed about where those people are hearing about you, and track that. Okay. So that's the kind of the best way. I know call tracking is great and we love technology, but like, it just is not super effective. I'll be the first to say that.
So what you're saying is we have to have a conversation on the phone.
Yeah.
So what you're saying is we have to really prod our customers and talk to them and try and understand what they're saying.
Yeah.
Okay. I like that.
Yeah. Thanks, Mo. I appreciate it.
Yeah. You've got some. And Stephanie said she uses both products and loves them. And I'm sure we could have a similar conversation around Automate Motivate. Do you want to talk a little bit about that product? And I'm not going to step on Martha's toes because I know she's going to get there. But you know, it's really hard to put a dollar value on retention with employees, right? And being able to keep them engaged and happy. So do you want to talk a little bit about the Automate Motivate product?
Automate Motivate is an easier one. So we've seen insane results with Automate Motivate as far as people that actually implement it in their business. Bobby, we'll just keep talking about Bobby because everyone talks about Bobby.
Well, he's not here. Or thank you, Bobby, I guess is what I meant.
Like, you know, in his business, he went from, you know, his technicians, he was saying, were averaging like $100 of upsells a month to averaging $3,000 in upsells a month. You know, so for a product that's, you know, $59, $79 a month, there's a massive ROI to that. And you can see that, right? And even if you got 5 Google reviews additional a month, you know, is $10 per Google review worth it? Probably. So, you know, there's a really big ROI on that. The marketing one is such a, you know, more tricky thing, right? Does sending brownies, does it get you an extra job? I don't know, but like over a period of time, yes, right? It's like if you, you know, I'm trying to think of something that like, it's the law of averages, right? Like, does sending this box get you another job from that customer? I don't know, but like, does sending 100 boxes That costs you a total of like $1,000, gets you, you know, $5,000 more of work over the year. We're really certain that it does, but it's just like really difficult for the people that like numbers, like you and me, to be like, if I do this today, like it's going to generate X tomorrow. It's tough to measure, but it goes back to like what Tay was talking about and creating that relationship.
Yeah, absolutely. Last week we had on like a super consumer. So we had my friend Lori, who like uses every home service in the book and like loves them. And she said, on average, a home service owner that has come to our house that she knows, likes, and trusts, she will send 10 paying referrals to per like home service owner. And so if you think about it, I don't know if it was a box of brownies that would tip her over, but like one box of brownies to get 10 more clients, that's pretty amazing. So I just want to share a quick, like, I don't want to call myself a pro because I feel like I'm not even using a tenth of what SendJim uses in my window cleaning business. And I'm working on it. Like, it's so good that I can like slowly integrate it, like Stephanie said, with my response bin. But for us, we use it sometimes for our email campaigns. And I know, Daniel, you're going to say that's not its intended use and you're not supposed to do that. But it works, and I can actually monetize that. So the last time I sent out a SendJim campaign to my list, I was trying to fill my calendar quickly. I booked over $18,000 worth of work in the first 4 hours. So I had like 42 customers book through my responsive link that I had embedded in my SendJim email. It was not pretty. I know it's not ideal. It was totally like a hack workaround, but it got me $18,000 in the calendar in less than 4 hours. And so there's something really beautiful about being able to communicate with your clients easily, quickly, pivoting. And I'm sure Michelle's going to talk to you about all those awesome integrations and responsive. So I'm going to also leave that one alone and tee you up to talk to Michelle about some systems. Thank you, Daniel, for trying to talk about those numbers with me. I know it's tricky, but we all know the value is there, right? We all know that value of a customer is there.
So two really quick things, and I'll be fast, Megan. You know, perfect is like, you know, the enemy of good, I think is the quote, or maybe I messed that up. But, you know, Josh says, like Josh Latimer, who's like a service titan, you know, in our industry, he always says like massive imperfect action. And like the SendJim email might not be pretty, or whatever you're doing, you might feel like is not good enough to go out. But look what you did. You took a not pretty email and you made $18,000. The voicemail, like it doesn't have to be brownies. Our voicemails are super inexpensive and it pushes people beyond their comfort edge, like a lot of times, but we're seeing a, you know, 3-6% response rate in the service industry. So you spend $100 sending, or you spend $34 sending 100 voicemails and, you know, you generate 3-6 jobs. Like that's huge on $34. So yeah, there's the numbers part for you.
Well, and Stephanie had two more comments. The beauty is it actually happens. So she sets up the system. It runs behind the scenes. She doesn't think about it. It happens every time. There's not going to be any human error or failure in that system failing. And she said, as a bonus, the brownies are delicious. So
thanks, Stephanie. You're awesome. Yeah.
And the handwritten cards. We haven't talked about those yet, but I'm a huge fan of the handwritten cards. I love that touch. So, okay, Michelle, systems. It's all you, girl.
Hi, thanks so much for joining here. I am last night and I dork new integration.
You're very slow. You're
the last couple. Am I slow? laughing. Am I?
Yeah, something.
Let's go to Martha for a minute, Michelle, while you refresh. Oh, Martha,
what's wrong with my internet?
Okay. It sounds like a drunken robot. It's awesome. Yeah. Sorry.
Get the hook. all right, Daniel. We'll see if Michelle can repair her problem over there. But anyway, so now, I didn't know you had a carpet cleaning business. You currently, or is that in the past? I missed that.
Currently, I'm 100% absentee like you, Martha.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So I know that you have to have people under control. Like you have to know how to run a great team to be able to do that. And you have to have good people in place to oversee things too. So let's talk a little bit about that. And I'm sure that Automate, Grow, Sell, there's something in there that you use as well to motivate your people. And I want to talk about that because a lot of our listeners are looking for maybe not to be absentee, but to be more absentee than they are right now. Mm-hmm. So I'd love to hear from you.
Yeah. So with me, it's all about aligning your employee incentives and goal alignment with your employees to what your goals are, so that they're incentivized when both of you win, right? You don't want to constantly fight the employee, because they will find ways to hurt you and win that battle, and they will wear you down, right? There's more of them than there are of you. So you need to find ways to where, like, when good things happen for you, good things are also happening for the employee. And when good things happen for the employee, good things happen for you. So how do we find those alignments? It's totally up to your business, but I think what Automate Motivate does and what we use it for is to understand what activities in your business add value, and how do you reward the employees for achieving those activities? Whether it's getting a Google 5-star review, getting no callbacks, you know, getting a certain quality score on their kind of report in the quality driven system, like whatever it is that adds value to your business, you want to incentivize your employees for doing. And so we define those things. We define how much they're worth to the business. And then we, you know, systematize that through a point system and rewards. That's more about what Automate Motivate does. But in general, you can do that without it, right? You just have to really understand what makes your employees, what they want, and how you can, and what you want, and how do you align those things so that you're both winning at the same time.
Yeah.
So that's pretty nebulous, but.
No, I go through a 10-week program with people, and the first week is talking about what do you need? Like, what are your pain points as a business mm-hmm. owner, and what do you need to fix? The second week is about what do they want? So what do employees want, and how are you going to align the two? And that is, I call it pay for performance. It can be, motivate, but we're right on the same track on that. Absolutely. It is. It's just, really, when you step back, it's fairly simple. It's just, I think it's getting over the mindset of, I could call this a Jeff Likesism, getting over the mindset of just do your damn job.
Yes.
That just doesn't work. And you have to figure out that aligning thing, which Jeff totally has. So,
Here's the thing, right? Is like, we have marketing systems in our business. We have sales systems. We have accounting systems. Like, we have all these systems, but like, raise your hand if you've got a people system in your business, and like 99% of people don't. And we all say like, hey, this is the most important asset, right? And so we say it and we recognize it and we say, hey, if this employee quits, like, I'd be devastated. But what are we doing from a system perspective to make sure that doesn't happen, or make sure our employees are happy, or make sure they're doing what they're supposed to be doing? And so it's like a huge, huge like mismatch of like what we say and know, but like what we actually do, because it's always like, well, how do I bring in the next dollar? How do I do this? And we don't think about, our people, and really they need intentional management,
right?
Or leadership, I should say, more than management.
Right. And Stephanie posted about a good way that she can keep tabs on her culture is how they're participating in Automate Motivate. And I have to admit, I don't use that product yet. I need to look into that. But very similar, Stephanie, like with we're having contests, or, we're having like a fun activity of the month. It could be that I just bombed on the idea and that it doesn't resonate with them. But more often than not, watching the participation is a really good gauge on how entrenched your employees are in the culture and how much they're loving their atmosphere.
Yes. Yeah. And so much to the point, Martha, that we want to develop a feature, and I'm going to be very clear right now that I don't have this started and I don't know if it will ever come. But
oh no, should you say that?
But we want to have a feature. It's part of my vision to have something that surveys the employee on a daily or a monthly basis. Just say, you know, it's, you know, up, you know, thumbs up or thumbs down or a thumbs neutral type thing, where it's like, how did you feel about your work environment this week, right? Mm-hmm. And like constantly asking them, and then understanding, to your point and Stephanie's point, about like, hey, we need to see the warning signs way ahead of time that this person is not engaged or is not having a good time at work, or there's something going on, so that we can manage that situation before it, you know, explodes.
Right.
Speaking Martha's language, she taught us how to do this. And we have it on our weekly bonus tracker where we survey our employees. And Martha, not to put words in your mouth, but the way she taught us was, you ask the employee, what's on a scale of 1 to 10, how happy were you with your job this week? And then what's one thing we could do to move that number 1 point higher? And Jeff can see before somebody quits probably on average 4 to 6 weeks ahead, because he'll see their numbers start trending down. He'll see what they're saying in their notes about they need from him to stay successful and happy in their position. And they'll be able to have that conversation early about whether they're going to do that.
I love that. I wrote that down.
That was all Martha.
It was from Culture Works. I'll give Chris Bosch credit. Everybody knows about surveying employees, but I love that what would move it 1 point question, follow-up question, a lot, because that gets the conversation going. And what I've found is, you know, and Megan, you guys have found this, that when you ask regularly and you act on what you can, like, you know, not everything they say that they want can you act on, but you can at least respond and give feedback as to why maybe you can't do that or when you could do that. But when they see their suggestions getting put in action and that you're actually listening, then you're going to get more and more open and honest feedback. And then it just keeps that dialogue going. So that's awesome. And the beauty of being able, like Stephanie said, you know, when you're looking at engagement, she can tell before it happens who is likely to drop off and, you know, go get a job somewhere else or whatever. And I mean, it's just like our clients. We are constantly trying to pull in new clients. You know, you need to be thinking the same, because not everybody that you get, client or employee, is a good fit for your company. And, you know, any of those telltale signs are great.
Yeah, 100%. Speaking my language, I love culture, and we practice what we preach here at SendJim with the culture. So that's awesome.
Yeah that's great. So let's see.
Stephanie's loving it. Loving all the things.
Let me just say, Stephanie is not a paid person. Yeah. I haven't paid her to say these things.
Neither is Mo, I don't think.
Yeah.
And I love that, Stephanie, like the distinction between QDS for surveying our clients and getting that actionable feedback, and then using a system like Automate, Motivate, or Michelle taught us how to do it in Bamboo HR, using a system like that to survey our internal customers. So, yeah. Michelle, can you try
my audio? Am I back?
Oh, you're good.
Oh, yay. Oh, goodness, what a weird thing. I didn't do anything, but it's been snowing here in Virginia, so a little crazy outside. So I am on the on the website, like I was saying earlier, last night, stalking all of the new integrations you guys have. I know that you just partnered up with WorkEasy tell me what it's like and how it helps a business owner that you have partnered with some of these CRMs to track the data or to pull the data out. Tell people how that process is for a business owner, if you don't mind.
It sounds like we need an integration between Automate, Motivate, and QDS. That sounds
like I like that.
But so we focused pretty heavily on integrations, Michelle, mostly because we've just, since I've been here, like I said, I'm a huge data person, and I wanted to understand like how the customers that got the most value out of SendJim, like what was it about them?
Sure.
And one of the things they have in common is that they integrated SendJim with another platform, right? They were taking advantage of the automation. Like SendJim's a great tool. It can make all these things we do easier, your direct mail marketing, all that stuff. But at the end of the day, like it's still a burden for the employee or the owner to do these things. So the people that got the most value are the ones that had this integration. And so we said, you know, we have a beautiful integration with ResponsiBid, and our users with ResponsiBid like never cancel. And they always like rave about us. And, you know, so it's like, how did we recreate that? Right. We had that with Jobber. And so, you know, we would have people with these other products come to us like House Call Pro and Service Titan and just say, hey, I want to use this, but you know, I don't know how. I can't like manually upload my list every week, et cetera. And so we've just made it a priority to help them automate these things. Yeah. Zapier is a huge automation tool. I don't know if your audience has heard of it, but if you haven't and you're looking for automation, it's a wonderful tool. It's basically a translator. Like if you imagine like two people that spoke two different languages, there's two software, you know, products that speak two different languages, and Zapier is the translator. So it can help those speak to each other without them, you know, speaking directly. And we have helped our customers. We've made it a huge point. Like if you don't know how to use Zapier, you don't know how to integrate, like we will do it for you because we want you to see the value that you can get out of our product. And so we've made these integrations with House Call Pro, Service Titan, Workies, and just trying to make other people aware and get the same value out that our ResponsiBid and Jobber users and Customer Factor users were getting.
That's awesome. I also noticed Compass Wave. Tell me about this one. That's one I wasn't familiar with. That was the only one I didn't know.
Compass Wave, I think, is a brand new sales or quoting tool in the maid service space.
Okay, cool.
I haven't worked with them much, but they reached out and asked if they could integrate. And so we said yes. And
I love it.
And I think it's like the infancy of a product. But if you are a maid service out there, you can check it out and see if it's for you. But it's all about, it's not a CRM, but it's about quoting, I think. Very similar to like a ResponsiBid, I think, but at a more basic level and very specific to maid service.
Cool. Okay. And then we did mention earlier the handwritten notes. I know that was something that everybody was super excited about last year. Tell us what that's looking like. And are you going to make any changes this year to handwritten notes, or is there anything on the boards for that?
So we actually, handwritten notes are the things I'm most excited about our system. It's the thing I use the most personally in my businesses. Sending a postcard is easy. Even making a phone call is easy. Like the thoughtfulness of like sending a handwritten card is like a lost art.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And like people just don't get that type of thing anymore. And so when they do, they're just blown away. And so I know it's more expensive, but for the $4 or $3.50 that you spend, like your customer just is blown away. So, we've seen usage increase heavily. And we're really excited about that. We just launched, you asked about like, is anything new coming with that? Now you can insert a gift card with your handwritten card. So our five most popular gift cards, like $5 Starbucks card, $10 Amazon card, I think there's five or six now that you can insert with your handwritten card. Again, I mean, you send a customer a handwritten card with a $5 Starbucks card. Like what window cleaning business does that, right? And like that just puts you over the top. And add $5 to your customer's bill and like pay for the card for, you know, they won't care, especially if you're doing things like that for them. So those are just like things that you can do. Like so much of our ecosystem as people today is digital. To put like a physical thing that you took time with to like actually write at least in the perception of your customer, is just, it's hard for me to like overstate it, what it does for you.
No, it's huge. I love it.
I have to add, because nobody has talked about this. So we set up, it was an automation, but we tried to make it not look like automation. But we set up a sequence for our employees. And so, like, I think 3 months, brownies, 6 months, a gift card, blah, 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 you know, with a note and everything. So, you know, for the listeners out there, you can absolutely set up these sequences for your clients and leads, but don't forget that you can use this as a retention tool too for your employees.
And our, and our referrals. We like the handwritten cards for referrals.
I like that. I like
always done like a thank you card, and poor Tammy, you know, she'd write like these thank you cards and address them and then, you know, stick a little coupon in them. And so that's really a nice personal touch for those referral sources.
That's a great idea.
Yeah. People also don't think about them from like a new customer acquisition standpoint, but, and depending on the service you're in, this may or may not make sense, but like for a maid service, for example, there's list groups out there. Like I think USA Home Listings is one of them. I may be wrong on the name, but you can subscribe to data services in your county where they can send you the name and address of people that just moved or just listed their house. Mm-hmm. And you can send them a handwritten card and just say, hey, I think you might be new to the area. You know, I'd like to introduce myself and my company. We provide the service. If, you know, I'd love to have an opportunity to work with you, et cetera. Right. If you send those to all the new people that move into the area, it's a phenomenal way to stand out. If you've ever bought in a house and moved into a new home or new area, you'll get like a million postcards, but you've never gotten a handwritten card. And awesome. It's just a, you know, a little trick that we've seen a few companies, our customers actually brought that to our attention because they were doing that. And they said that was their sole customer acquisition
time. Wow.
And so I was pretty surprised by that.
Hey, for us, I'm just going to add one comment. And the realtor who sold that house ends up being a much bigger source to us than the new homeowner. So the realtor who sold that house, we send them gift cards to our services for like $50 off because our services average $400. And to set up an automated system to do that as opposed to the old way. I remember I was shocked. Like our little town of 60,000 people has 350 plus realtors. So you know that's a lot of handwritten cards and vouchers, but this is a system where you can automate that really easily, effectively, and inexpensively. So sorry, I cut off both Martha and Michelle for that comment.
I love it. I was gonna say Mo asked what the name was. I think maybe he's talking about Workflow. I'm not sure.
I think he was talking about Compass Wave.
Compass Wave. Yeah, it's on their website. And okay. I'll put a link up to SendJim for everybody to check out as part of your homework. So,
and shout out to Mo. I haven't seen Mo since we tried to go skydiving together. And there was a little accident while we were there. So the group didn't get to skydive. But that was a fun day, right, Mo? not for that person. They did survive. So,
okay, Martha, I'm gonna pass Daniel on to you. We're all done with this. Thank you.
We're all out of sorts today. We're going in the wrong order here. So Daniel, just so you know, we do a round robin where we assign one homework topic and. The goal, if you're new to this audience, if you're new to this show, the goal is we don't want you to do all four or five. We want you to just do one. If you can do one homework assignment every week to move your business forward, choose the one that speaks to you. Do it. We have the Facebook group. You can report back. We'll offer you some support, some accountability. And Daniel, you can decide if anything comes up that you'd like to assign as homework, or you can just listen to our homework. No pressure either way. And we're going to start with Tay.
Awesome. So I am going to have y'all look into SendJim for specifically the relationship marketing. So I want you to, I know it's going to have the ability to give you new customers. I know you can do the five rounds. I know you can be able to target customers that are brand new, but I want you to do the research on SendJim this week. on how to be able to really build those relationships with your current clients. So that's my homework for you. And I'm sure I'm probably kind of piggybacking off Michelle based upon our earlier comments. So you'll just kind of have to wrap up both of ours together, most likely.
Okay. I like it.
All right. And for finance homework, we have done the math exercise several times of what's the value of a customer to you. I don't think we've ever done in this group the value of your internal customer. So Debbie Sardone was the first one that asked me to do this math. And my mind was completely blown when I did this math. I couldn't believe it. I'd made it like over 10 years in business and I'd never thought about how much does one good employee generate for your business in income? How much does one good employee generate? And then think about Daniel's idea for, I don't know what you said, $49 a month or $79 a month, or Martha's culture first class for, I don't know, $190. I don't know any of these prices, but for these simple tricks of retaining one good key player, like, of course you should be investing in that. Of course you should be investing in your people. I will give you just a little range. I'm in California. We have a window cleaning business, but one average, not even exceptional, one average window cleaner in our company generates over $75,000 in income. And that is, that's pretty amazing to me. So that is my homework. Figure out, and if you don't know how to start, you know, think about your charge rate and then how many hours they're actually charging per day and then how many days they're working per year. That's the calculation and the formula for figuring out the value of one of your internal customers, otherwise known as your employees.
Okay. And our systems homework is to check out SendJim this week and look at all of the cool integrations that they're working on with Zapier. So amazing list of home service CRMs. There's everybody's pretty much on this list. So please get on there and take a look this week. They do have a free trial. So I would encourage anybody that's not a user of SendJim to try out the service for free. Get in there, poke around, try a few things, send yourself something. It's a great platform, really is. So that's
can
your
I
homework.
Add to that real quick?
Yeah, please.
So
please.
With your free trial, we will spend we'll offer like a 45-minute demo call. Book the demo with us. Let myself or one of my people, Alicia is one of my team members who does demos well. She's a rock star. And we can help you. Like maybe you think your CRM doesn't integrate. Maybe we can help you with Zapier, make sure that we can automate it for you. And we can see how it could work for your business. If it doesn't work, no hard feelings. But like let us be like a 45-minute consultant to you and just see if we can figure something out. So that's what I would ask. If you do the free trial, let us talk to you for 45 minutes. It's not going to be a sales pitch. It's going to be how can we help you add value?
Yeah. Love it. Okay. Awesome.
Okay. And my homework is going to be check out, I thought somebody would take this homework by now. So, but to check out Automate, Grow, Sell and see what they can do to help you with your culture. I have to go check it out myself. Stephanie was talking about, and Stephanie is she's a hardcore QDS user. And it sounds like she's a hardcore
automate motivate.
I couldn't think of what that was. But yeah, so it sounds like those two really can gel, and we need to talk about that, Daniel, because we have the data that drives performance programs. And, you know, I think my homework is to talk to you, but the listener's homework is to check out Automate, Motivate.
Absolutely. And our Automate, Motivate also has a, it's the first month is free right now. That's a new year special. I was just looking on our own website to see what our team did for the new year, but the first month is free and it's normally $79 a month. There's also a link that Megan just posted where you can get it for $59 a month. That's forever. So it never, you know, goes up to the 79. So it saves you $20 a month for our Fight Club for Business listeners. If you have any questions about either of those things, just do the quick chat.
And I did bad math, so I have to correct myself just in case anybody's like, wow, that seems low. Our average employee brings in $117,000, not $75,000. I don't know where that number came from. So anyway,
path for, what was it, $59 a month, you can work on a system for your culture to help retain those employees. Yeah. And both of those links will be posted in the group with our homework assignments.
Yeah, I love those homework assignments. I don't know that I want to give any more homework. I hated homework as a kid, and I think that those are fantastic. Just ask that you go to either automatemotivate.com and check out our product and start a free trial, or sendjim.com and start a free trial, and get in contact with us. Talk to us about one of those things. We can see if we can make it add value to your business. And we are, our culture is all about like empowering you as a business owner, and we are here to help. If it means setting up the automation for you, if it means teaching you about something, if it means sending you to an educational course, connecting you with another software product, like, we will do whatever it takes to add value to your business, even if it doesn't generate any revenue for us. So use us as a resource, come to our website, start a chat with us, do something on our website. That's my homework, I guess.
Love that.
Sounds good. All right.
Quote for the week. Our quote for the week is actually very apropos for what we talked about today. And it's, the biggest mistake a small business can make is to think like a small business. So a lot of these tools that we talked about today can really help you be a bigger business in your market. And we love that. We love that you can think bigger and use some of these awesome tools. So thank you so much, Daniel, for coming and joining us today. I really appreciate it. It was great.
Thank you. I appreciate the opportunity to not only speak with you ladies, but to interact with your audience. And I had a lot of fun. So thank you.
Yeah, it was good.
Okay. And we'll see everybody next week, Tuesday morning, 7 a.m. Pacific, 10 a.m. Eastern, right here on Fight Club for Business Facebook page.
Yay.
All right. Bye, everybody. Have a good day.
Connect with Fight Club for Business. Join our Facebook group, where we have weekly homework, accountabilities, and an awesome community to help you fight for your business. Facebook.com/Fight Club 4 Fight Club for Business.